My name is Gary Raposa, and I'm an application engineer here at Agilent Technologies. Today I want to talk to you about testing DC-to-DC optimizers or DC-to-DC converter using a solar array simulator made by Agilent Technologies. I have here an example of a DC-to-DC converter, as I said, also known as a DC optimizer. This one happens to be made by Texas Instruments, and it's a prototype of one of their designs. And what I'll be doing is I'll be providing the input voltage for this DC optimizer and from the solar array simulator, and I have the output hooked up to just one of our Agilent electronic loads in order to pull power from the optimizer. So let's take a look at how that all works. I'm going to turn the instruments on and you'll hear the fan noise come up here in just a moment. Okay, so I've turned the instruments on, and now I have the power running into the DC to DC converter coming from the solar array simulator, and I've also got the electronic load pulling power out of the DC to DC converter. And I have some demonstration software that I want to show you, which will demonstrate some of the capabilities of the solar array simulator. So let's take a quick look at that. On the software, there's a graph that shows current on the vertical axis on the left side here in blue, and on the right side in green is the power. So the IV curve is shown in blue, I being current, V on the horizontal axis being voltage. And this is the present IV curve. Also, the red crosshairs that you see on there, those red crosshairs are the actual operating point, the present operating point of the solar array simulator. So you can see it's operating right at the maximum power point on this green curve. The green curve shows the power comes up and it goes back down again. That's the power available from that IV curve. IV curve being simulated by the solar array simulator, simulating what would come out of a real solar panel. So it's the job of that DC to DC optimizer to keep that operating point right at that peak of the green curve. So let's see what happens here. What I can do in this demonstration software is I can move the cloud back and forth in front of the sun to block some light, and that will move the IV curve. It's really changing the IV curve on the SAS, and as a result, we see that the red crosshairs are continuing to stay at the peak of that power curve, right at that maximum power point right there, no matter what the sunlight is. So as I increase the sunlight here again, the IV curves will go up, and the microconverter is able to track that maximum power point. That's what its job is. So again, we've got the SAS providing the DC input power to the converter. The output of the converter is going to an Agilent electronic load, just pulling a constant amount of current from the converter. And as the sunlight blocks the sun, we have less light available, less power available, but this still harvests as much power as possible from the IV curve. So we just saw how the Agilent Technologies solar array simulator is able to provide DC input power to something like a DC to DC optimizer in order to test it and make sure that it's able to provide power at that maximum power point, and all the other attributes of a DC optimizer or DC to DC converter. Once again, the Agilent E4360A solar array simulator really is an ideal instrument in order to provide that input power to test a product like a DC to DC converter or a DC optimizer.